Good evening, people watching Miss 65, Lisa Boyce. I'm going to give you a verse of scripture. Things are spicing up now. Let me give you this verse of scripture out of Jeremiah 29:11. Now, you all should know this by heart. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Now, he's talking to Israel, but like I said before, you can use these verses and apply them to yourself. That's the Lord speaking. Let me give you the gospel. It's in 1 Corinthians 15:1-4. Christ shed his blood for all of our sins, past, present, and future, was buried, and rose again on the third day according to scripture. We're saved by grace through faith in Christ alone. That's why we're saved, how we're saved, how we're kept saved. It's only through his death, burial, resurrection, and his blood. It is grace, something we didn't earn, something we do not deserve, that God gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him will not perish but have eternal life. How do you come to that? You admit you're a sinner in need of Christ. The moment you put your faith and trust in Christ and his blood, the moment you accept him as Savior, not only are you saved, but you are justified by the blood of Jesus. You are protected by the blood of Jesus. You are rapture ready, which is, yeah, it's going to happen at any time. And you're sealed until the day of redemption, which means you cannot and will not lose your salvation. The Holy Spirit will indwell in you, lead you, guide you, minister to you, encourage you, speak to you, teach you, and change you if you let him. If you let him. Now is the time to let him. So this is off of Hal Turner. I know. What can I say? Hal. I've said it before, and you know, don't write me telling me, well, you know, Hal is this. I know what Hal is about. Hal don't like Israel. I know that. But unfortunately, he has news. And unfortunately, it's accurate. Now, I'm getting word, and I don't have this yet, but I'm getting word that they have cut off power in Venezuela. Now, I don't know whether New York Prepper is saying this or not. I think he did say that. I am hearing that they have cut off power in Venezuela because this thing has gotten, well, off the chain over there. But according to this right here about Israel, Israel drops a bomb on one of the most densely populated areas. The senior Hezbollah official targeted in Beirut was, I think his name is Haj Mashan or Mashin. Haj Mashin is reportedly the commander of Hezbollah's precision missile project. So this is huge. They are also calling him the number two of Hezbollah. However, he's saying that his sources tell him that Fayyad Shoukry was the target of the Israeli assassination attempts. Shoukry was reportedly responsible for the Hezbollah operations. So due to successful Hezbollah counterintelligence, the Israeli assassination attempt in Beirut, there he's saying it was unsuccessful because they got the wrong, according to him, they got the wrong guy. Now, let me explain something to you about him. I don't believe that. I'm just saying. I don't believe that. Let me look at something. Hold on a minute. Now, according to I'm looking at Keegan's site right now. Okay, so according to this, and this is off of Israel News. It says here that IDF confirms Hezbollah's number two, Fayyad Shoukry, was eliminated. Now it says, also says the IDF announced Tuesday night that in a targeted intelligence-based elimination, Israeli Air Force fighter jets eliminated the Hezbollah terrorist organization's most senior military commander and the head of the strategic unit Fayyad Shakar. Known as, I guess, Sayyid Mushan in the area of Beirut. Now, it sounds like he goes by a different name. He goes by the same name here. He served as Hezbollah's Secretary General Hassan Nasrallah's right-hand man and has Nasrallah's advisor for planning and directing wartime operations. So he has directed Hezbollah's attacks on the state of Israel since October 8th. And he was the commander responsible for what happened Saturday. Now, that's what's being said here. Excuse me. So it says, he goes by the same name. Fuad Shakar Sayyid Mushan. He goes by the exact same name. So he joined the Hezbollah terrorist organization in 1985, held a number of senior positions. As the head of Hezbollah's strategic unit, he was responsible for the majority of Hezbollah's most advanced weaponry, including precise guided missiles, cruise missiles, anti-ship missiles, long-range rockets, and UAVs. He was responsible for force buildup planning and execution of terror attacks against the state of Israel. So this is what is being said right now. And I had a cat come in here. So hold on a minute. Sorry about that. I had to close the door when she opened the door because Zach is making a lot of noise on his game. So, but anyway, this goes on. This is the same person from what I'm seeing here. So this is why I have to be careful with Hal Turner and his reporting. Yeah, see, he didn't get that right at all. So this goes on to say here, and this, again, this is off of 7 Israel National News, and if anybody should know anything, it's Israel. Earlier Tuesday, contradictory reports emerged as to whether Shakar survived or not, with the most recent reports stating that he was eliminated. Shakar has played a role in the 1983 bombing of the U.S. Army barracks in Beirut, in which 241 American servicemen were taken out. So this guy is not missed at all. Now, Hal goes on to give hour by hour details of what's going on right now. That I can kind of look at. So it says the Iranian foreign minister said that Hezbollah has the right to respond to the Israeli attack. So at 4:49, U.S. warships were moving closer to Lebanon in order to carry out evacuations of U.S. nationals. Israeli fighter jets have and are taking off heading north. 5:03, reports of explosions near the headquarters of Hezbollah battalions in Babylon. How appropriate is that? Babylon, Iraq. Yeah. Multiple airstrikes were carried out in Al-Shakar, southern Baghdad. Reports indicate the 7 members of the PMF, specifically the Katib Hezbollah, were taken out following airstrikes targeting northern Babal in Iraq. Hezbollah will soon issue an official statement regarding the Israeli attack on the southern suburbs of Beirut. Israeli jets flying over Tel Aviv heading north. This thing is just starting, folks. This is just starting. And it's one of those things where we just have to sit back and wait and see what the Lord's going to do. That's what we're doing. Wait and see. Hurry up and wait and see. 5:10. Target of Israeli attack in Beirut. Hezbollah, caught by surprise by strike, did not expect IDF to attack in the heart of Beirut. A ballistic missile launched from Iraq has been intercepted approaching Israeli airspace near the city of Eilat. GPS is down nationwide in Israel, completely jammed. Raising alert in Tel Aviv and Tiberias in anticipation of missile strikes from Hezbollah. So this announcement came also from the IDF. This is a letter here. And it says the IDF announces today that the targeted intelligence-based elimination, Israeli Air Force fighter jets eliminated the Hezbollah terrorist organization most senior military commander and the head of a strategic unit, Fayyad Shakar, better known as Saeed Mashin or Mashan, in the area of Beirut. He served as Hezbollah's secretary general to Hassan Nasrallah's right-hand man and was Nasrallah's advisor. And it goes on to talk about this in this little letter right here. So at 5:39, Israel saying that they do not want war. So the U.S. State Department saying no need to escalate to a war. U.S. military saying we will defend Israel if war commences. Well, kind of late for that now because Hezbollah is kind of ticked off right now. And it's going to be a war as planned. So, reports suggest Hezbollah are going to launch a major escalation. And that just came out 2 hours ago or 2.5 hours ago. Israeli Army radio estimates indicate that the attack will lead to a major response from Hezbollah in the north, but it will lead to a response from Hezbollah in Tel Aviv or in Jerusalem. Russia, here we go. Here we go, right now. Russia says strikes on Lebanon are a flagrant violation of international law. The senior journalist close to Hezbollah warns, don't stay in Haifa tonight. The Iranian embassy in Beirut, we condemn the strongest terms, the sinful and cowardly Israeli aggression against the southern suburb of Beirut, which claimed the lives of a number of martyrs and wounded. Hezbollah, 552, Hezbollah's first response to the attack in Beirut. Israel, quote unquote, made a Now, they said in another, I saw this, they said, made a grave mistake, quote unquote. Shelters open in central Israel municipalities amid Hezbollah strike threat. Shelters have been opened in municipalities across central Israel in anticipation of a potential strike from Hezbollah following the strike, Israeli strike in Beirut. Update 619. Let me see if he's done anything else after this. And I'm getting... Yes, he did. So, he did another update here just a few minutes ago. So, this 619 new airstrikes occurring on the city of Babal in Iraq. Strategic military cargo planes arrive in Israel at the Al Udeid Air Base in Qatar. A swarm of drones enters Israel from Lebanon towards Western Galilee. Israel opened all shelters in Tel Aviv. Now, the update is at 6:58. He just did this a half an hour ago. Israel now officially confirms the death of Fayyad Shakir Haj Mashan, top commander of Hezbollah's military. It is possible that the head of the Quds force of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps was also killed in a strike in Beirut. Wow, this is just beginning. This has started and this is just beginning. The Lebanese Ministry of Health, this is a report at 7:20. The Lebanese Ministry of Health, the number of victims of the Israeli attack on the southern suburb of Beirut has risen to three deceased and 74 wounded so far. So that's what we got so far. So I will link all this in the description box because it's not behind a payload. And I will link the other article from the Israel News, 7 Israel National News to the description box as well. If anything else comes up, I will be back on, and we'll see what happens, because God's got to get involved in this thing. I don't see it going no other way. The way things are happening now, you got this thing that's going on in Venezuela. You got all this stuff going. I told you Russia was going to get involved in this somehow. Because if Iran is going to get involved, Russia is definitely going to get involved. Then you got China that's going to get involved in it. Then you got North Korea that's going to get involved in it. So there's your 200 million man army right there in the book, in the Armageddon War, you know, 200 million man army. Well, if you think about it, China has close to that, but they don't have enough. So if you add North Korea and other nations, there's your army right there. So, yeah. It's all leading up to Armageddon, folks, which means that the rapture is nigh, right now, near, soon, any hour now. Praise God. My lips to God's ears. Your lips to God's ears as well. So, hang in there, folks. It's almost over. For real. It is literally almost over. I'll be back later. Thank you.